I think it should be 1,200. I think we should do at least what we did in the CARES Act. I mean, listen, working families, they need help. They need support. And listen, remember, when this started out, they were going to get zero. So this is good movement in the right direction. I think it needs to be 1,200. Let's see what they actually come up with.
Everything that is in that package is vitally needed. The problem is it is a much smaller amount than the country needs in this moment of economic desperation. The working class of this country, frankly, is in worse shape economically than any time since the Great Depression.
Well, strange bedfellows there as far as pushing for extra stimulus in this coronavirus relief package. Senator Bernie Sanders and Senator Josh Hawley, we're back with our panel. Mark, it looks like they're heading towards about $700 in direct stimulus and an increase in unemployment benefits, but the package itself is long delayed.
Oh, very long delayed. I mean, look, the Democrats, Pelosi and Schumer, have been holding up COVID relief since July in order to hurt Donald Trump in the election. And then since Election Day, they've been holding it up in order to help the trial lawyers. I mean, literally, there was broad agreement on most of the rest of the package. So there's agreement on a new PPP loans for small businesses and unemployment aid and all the rest of it. The two outstanding issues were the Democrats' insistence on money for state and local governments and the Republicans' insistence on some kind of limited temporary liability protection for these businesses that courageously stayed open during the pandemic. And Democrats have basically said, we'd rather not give in on liability than get the $160 billion in state and local aid. They are literally giving up one of their top priorities because they are so in the pocket of the trial lawyers. It's really remarkable.
You know, Jonathan, the PPP program, which helps a lot of small businesses, will get reloaded if everything gets across the finish line by about $250 billion. It seems like this is a step to another step, perhaps, when the Biden administration takes over.
Well, that's what some moderate Democrats, I mean, you know, Joe Manchin and others, Senator Manchin, have said, you know, this is not the be-all and end-all. We'll have another go at this next year. But, you know, I've talked to a number of progressives, including senior advisor to Bernie Sanders, Faz Shakir, and they're not assuming that there's another bite at the apple next year. And I frankly think that that's the right assumption to make. If you base it on history, there's no reason to think that if McConnell is in control of the Senate next year, that he's going to entertain another stimulus bill in the neighborhood of $1 trillion. We've become used to these type of bills in the era of COVID, of the pandemic, but historically, it's very hard to get these things done. So you've got one of the reasons you've had so much argument and tension is the progressives look at this as their one shot to get a massive stimulus through, and they may be right.
Yeah, and nobody, Democrat or Republican, has been talking about the national debt or the deficits that may start factoring in. Speaking about the Democrats, take a listen to Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez talking about leadership in her party.
In that CARES Act in March, I do think that we, the Democratic Party, gave up a lot of leverage. We essentially gave away $4 trillion in leveraged funds to Wall Street.
Are you ready to say Pelosi and Schumer need to go?
I mean, I think so. I mean, and the question is, like, this year, for example, the hesitancy that I have is that I want to make sure that if we're pointing people in a direction, that we have a plan.
Kimberly, she went on to say that she's worried that more conservative Democrats would try to take over the Pelosi spot.
This is going to be the biggest story of this next year, the thing to watch. One of the consequences of Nancy Pelosi losing those seats that she did is she has a very narrow majority and a very divided party. And with a Democratic president in charge, there's going to be a lot of assertion from progressives to start getting what they want.
All right, panel, thank you very much. Stay warm, stay dry.